Hello everyone, I'm Sonali. In this part, you will learn macros and preprocessor in C programming. What is the preprocessing? What is the role of this preprocessor? Actually, preprocessor is a program that processes the source program before it is passed onto the compiler, before it converts our source code into the object code. We are doing the some preprocessing. And while the preprocessing, there is some modifications on the source code based on the instructions provided by the preprocessor. Actually, preprocessor is a collection of special statements called directives that are executed at the beginning of the compilation process. We are using the hash in each and every program. When we are writing the program, hash include, we are giving here the header file like this, hash include stdio.h. Okay. Include the header file into the program. Which header file? The specified header file into program. Actually, preprocessor directives are processed by a program is known as a preprocessor. What are the uses of this preprocessor? It makes your program easy to modify. It is simple to use. It increases the program's portability and improves the readability of your program. We are using the preprocessor directives in our program. What is the format of these directives? Do the hash and your directive name and identifying string. Okay. We are using mostly this directive. Conditional directives. Okay. We are using the hash if df, hash if and df, hash if, hash else, hash elif. Okay. We are using this directive also. Unconditional directives. We are using the hash define, hash include, hash undefined, etc. And some miscellaneous directives like hash, then double hash for the token merge, then hash error define function and hash line function. We are using these different directives in your inner program. Macro. What is actually the macro? Macro is a small part of a code. Okay. We are using this small part of a code. Whenever the name is used in your program, at that time we are calling this code in our program. Okay. Macro is a small part of a code that is given a name. Whenever the name is used, it is replaced by the contents of the macro. When we are calling this name, at that time this line is executed here. Okay. Hash define preprocessor directive. We can define the macros like this. Okay. There are the two types of macro, simple macro and parameterized macro for the function like macros. Simple macro substitution. Okay. It is used to simple replacement of identifier by a string. We are using this constant 53.14. Here we are using this directive. See this. Unconditional hash define. Okay, we are using this unconditional directory here. Hash define 53.14. There is no need to choose the semicolon for this. Each and every preprocessor directory starts with a hash sign, and here is no semicolon. Okay, not necessary to choose the semicolon. Then int main float here one variable radius and one area. Enter the radius. Here we are accepting the radius. Then area equals to pi into radius. See, this pi automatically replaced with this value 3.14 because it is a simple replacement of identifier by a string. Here, area of circle, calculate the area of circle here and display the area of circle. Next type is parameterized macro or function like macro. Okay, here we are using the function like macro. Macro that takes the parameter is known as parameterized macro. Here is one example for this. To calculate square of number using macro. Hash include stdio.h. This is our header file. Then hash define square. Here is a macro. Square and these are the parameters. Okay, square of x is x into x. No need to do the brackets here and semicolon here. Okay, int main. Then int p equals to square of 5. When we are doing the call to this function, automatically this 4 will replace here. Okay, square of 5. Then the square of 5 is 5 into 5. So here is your answer. Store this answer in a P and display the square of 5 is equal to here. Let's execute this program on Turbo C. You can use any operating system according to your ability of operating system. I'm using the Turbo C for this. Here is our first program. Calculate area of circle using macro. Okay, here is a radius, area, enter the radius. Here I'm using the function type, function return type int. You can use the void also, but when you are using here void, you here get ch. Okay, here I'm writing the return 0 only. So let's execute this program, Alt F9 and Control F9 to run. Okay, enter the radius. Here, this first three lines are previous program output. Okay, enter the radius 4. Enter. Okay, so how to see this output of this program when you are using the int main and return 0? At that time, press Alt F5, Alt and F5 to see the output of this program. Before this, here give CLRSCR, clear screen to erase the previous program output. Then compile the program and run your program. Okay, here is your radius, radius is entered 5. Okay, so press Alt and F5 to see the output. Okay, Alt F5 to see the output of your program. Or you can change it into, just here write void. So if the function type is void, no need to return value, only write here get ch. Okay, and check the output. Alt F9, Control F9, enter the radius 5. Here is your output. Okay, and then save the program. Click on the file and save, or simply press F2. Okay, then let's see one more program for this macros. I have stored this file as macro2.c. So open this file first, then see here. To calculate the square of number using macro, here is a function of square. Square of x equals to x into x. Let's execute this program at F9, Control F9. Okay, so execute. Then Alt F5 to see the output. Okay, output is square of 5 is 25. Okay, here also need to do the CLRSCR, clear screen. Here is the previous program output. See, if here is a space in between. Okay, let's check it. Alt F9, then here is an error. What is error? Undefined symbol X. So, don't give the space when you are defining the variable. You are writing the definition of macro here. Okay, you can use this square. Okay, suppose you want to calculate the cube, then you can use the one more function, hash define. You can use the any function here, cube of y. Then y into y. You can use this function. Okay, no need to do the semicolon. Just here take one more variable, or you can directly write printf/n cube of 4 equals to %d, comma, call this function here cube and pass the value 4. Okay, you can accept this value from user also. Okay, then let's execute the program. Control F9. Okay, then Alt F5 to check the output. So, square of 5 is 25 and square of 4 is 16. In this way, you can perform the different programs. Try more programs based on this macro and preprocessor. Thank you.